Sulfur hexafluoride. SF6. Which atom do you think is the central atom? You see, you could have never done Lewis structures before and go, sulfur? And you'd be right. We'll learn how to use electronegativity when it's needed later. Usually, in a molecule, the central atom is the first one. Not always, but usually. Now we have six fluorines. How are we going to distribute those fluorines about the central atom? If you've done Lewis structures before, you may have this idea of four stuck in your head. Look at the rules. It says arrange the surrounding atoms about the central atom. It doesn't say make sure there are only four at most surrounding atoms about the central. So it's SF6, the six fluorines, all around the sulfur. For the valence electron count, we look at each atom So sulfur is in column 6A, six valence electrons. Fluorine is in column 7A, seven valence electrons. There are six of them. So there's 48. Divide that by 2, we get 24. So we have to distribute all 24 pair of electrons. What's the next rule? Bond the surrounding atoms to the central atom. And I'm using a line to represent a bond. And each line represents a pair of electrons. And the line is nice because it looks like it's hooking up each fluorine to the sulfur. So now we've distributed six pair of electrons. We still have more to go. What's the next rule? Follow the octet rule for the surrounding atoms. So we look at that bottom fluorine. See, it's already sharing one pair of electrons with sulfur, so we need to add three more to the fluorine. So that gives us four around that fluorine. And we add three more pair to each of the fluorines, keeping track of our count as we go through this. Okay, so we've satisfied the octet rule for the surrounding atoms. Next rule says, place any remaining electron pair around the central atom. We'll count up how many we've distributed. We've got four pair around each fluorine, six fluorines, 24 pair. We're out. Next rule, if the central atom has fewer than four pair of electrons, how many does the central atom have? It's actually got six. Okay, so we'll ignore that rule. And it's next rule, if needed, check and adjust the formal charges. This one's not needed. We won't worry about formal charge just yet until you need to learn about it. So let's ignore that for the time being, then you'll learn how to invoke it. And some terminology. The pair of electrons that are around each fluorine and isolated only on fluorine, those are called lone pair electrons. And then each pair that's being shared with another atom, it's a bonding pair. So remember the idea about octet rule, 8. So look at the bottom fluorine. Where do you remember 8 from? You've seen it. The noble gas that's in the same row as fluorine is neon, and that has a valence configuration of 4s2, 2p6, 8 valence electrons. That's where the octet rule comes in. There's a stability that comes in from 8 electrons. That's why you're going to see that again and again and again. On the other hand, how many electron pair are around sulfur? Six pair, which is more than four. So look at those rules again. If the central atom has fewer than four pair, doesn't say you can only have four pair around it. There are times when you can have more than four pair of electrons around sulfur. Something to make note, the only time you can have more than four pair about the central, that's when the central atom is in row 3 or greater, not row 2. And this is a real molecule, sulfur hexafluoride. You may have seen it on Mythbusters or Big Bang Theory. You inhale it and it lowers your pitch so you get a really, really deep voice. Whereas if you inhale helium, that raises your pitch, real high-pitched squeaky voice. If you get a hold of sulfur hexafluoride, don't inhale it. It's very, very dense. It's dangerous to breathe in because it's hard to expel out of your lungs. So when they did this on the Big Bang Theory, they didn't really do it. They just did voice modulation. On Mythbusters, though, they did actually do it. They had an EMT standing by. I believe it was Adam who inhaled it in case he had problems getting it out of his lungs. You may have seen some explanations. When I was taking general chemistry, the explanation that showed up in textbooks typically was you can use d orbitals to have what we call a hypervalent compound. In other words, a central atom has more than four pair of electrons. No, that's not really the idea here, the d orbital thing. What it really is it involves things like valence bond theory, molecular orbitals, because it's a molecule, it's not an atom. Take a look. Maybe your textbook has a better explanation. Wikipedia has a decent explanation. Look up hypervalent. You can read about it.